5 of us had grown up together, so when our own families went dysfunctional, we became one for each other. We were the Bachelor's Club, and Rick always had his phasers locked on anything that threatened it. Adulthood scared all of us, but Rick, he avoided it like kryptonite. Broadcasts of television shows that originally aired 20 and 30 years ago are now reaching other solar systems. Aliens will watch our TV shows before we ever establish contact with them. And when we do, the first thing they'll want to know is whether anyone saved the castaways on Gilligan's Island. 400 years in the future, the crew of the Starship Enterprise could be watching the transmissions of old Star Trek episodes that are just arriving in the Gamma Quadrant. Will Kirk and Spock watch reruns of things that haven't happened to them yet? I keep replaying this one particular night in my mind, in the second year of my 5-year mission to get out of college.
Put me through the Capone rules.
Just a moment, sir.
Yeah? Let me talk to Capone.
Who's calling?
Just tell him Elliot Ness.
Tell you.
Mom said watching TV exposed you to too much radiation. Watching it was like working in a nuclear power plant. Especially when you sat real close to one of those big 24-inch sets that glowed forever when you turned them off. If anyone ever doubted the bad effect TV had on us, my friend Rick exemplified it in tragic living color. But this one particular night was his personal season finale. With. My friends only saw her as a threat, so they didn't care that in a few hours she was going to Nepal to spend a year abroad. I was scared of losing her. So I resolved not to lose her. I'd show her I wasn't a coward about life. Even if I was too frightened to take off my shirt to get in my own pool with her. At least it wasn't a Nepalese swimming pool, which are probably just glorified toilets for the monkeys to piss in. So I did the bravest thing that any scared, cowardly, shirt-wearing, monkey piss-fearing guy could do. I know I should have been more concerned she'd contract amoebic dysentery from eating bad yak butter, but I was just terrified she'd say no.
Ah, oh, Jesus, tequila? Watch it, Katie's armed.
Watching the Untouchables again, Rick? Never point a gun at more woman than you can handle.
Do you know you're more than I can handle if you never give me a chance?
Give it up, Rick. You gotta face it. She's got taste.
Pile on! No, no! I hereby call to order this meeting of the Bachelors and Bachelorettes Club. And welcome, John.
Back into the fold.
One of our founding members.
Saved from the nefarious clutches of domesticity and coupled up.
Guys, I appreciate this, but this exchange program doesn't last forever. I mean, she's coming back.
In a year?
She'll have fallen for some Swiss ski instructor named Lars.
Come on, gang, give me a break. We're not a gang.
We're a club!
My boy's in that tree again.
It sounds like a job for Superman.
They watch way too much TV.
Kate, what would you say if I told you, well, that I gave Laura an engagement ring?
John, last week you said that you and Laura were going to break up.
Who knows if I'm doing the right thing? I mean, marriage is a major step.
Rick will see this as the end of the club.
I know.
It'll break his heart.
Well, Laura might not even say yes.
What do you mean? She hasn't given you an answer yet?
I trusted Kate with my shameful secret. But Headboard had already figured it out, and that's when Rick got on the case.
Oh, my God. When did this godforsaken, ghoulish nightmare happen?
Just a couple action rules ago. She hasn't even awoken to see the ring of war yet.
Rick wasn't exactly in love with love. His brother's marriage failed like the O-ring on the space shuttle, and his parents' relationship was like an episode of Night Gallery.
Pale face seem even paler, Kimo Sabi. What wrong?
John.
What, is he dead?
No. He's engaged.
John?
John.
One Adam, 12.
Is this what's left? Sitting by and watching a sequence of doomed marriages destroy the lives of our best friends and pull the group apart, member by member?
We'll just have to change his mind.
He's already given her a ring.
I can't believe that the Rick I grew up with would give up this easily. I mean, did Spock give up on Captain Kirk when he was lost in the Tholian web?
No.
Did Starsky give up on Hutch when the mob made him a heroin addict?
No.
Did the Chief give up on Maxwell Smart when he was brainwashed by chaos?
No.
Absolutely not. Tonto?
You get him up to my car. You tell him I have a surprise for him. I'll meet you there. Headboard.
Giver?
Has she awakened and seen it yet?
Nope.
Then for John's sake, we can't let her. And your mission, should you decide to accept it, is to maintain secrecy about what you've seen.
Rick?
And what I'm about to do.
I'm pissing out. Some said Rick's heart was two sizes too small.
Why'd you figure Kate won't tell us who this new one is, this Racer X?
I hate to break it to you guys, but it's me. Yeah, she just didn't want to tell Terry here. She decided to sleep with me and not him.
Right. So, what's the surprise anyway?
It's over at Terry's crib. Let's cruise.
I can't leave. Laura's getting on a plane in 6 hours.
She's passed out. Besides, you'll be back in 5.
5 minutes. No 3-hour tour.
3-hour tour.
The weather started getting rough. The tiny ship was tossed.
If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the minnow would be lost. The minnow would be lost.
Green Acres is the place to be. For Lynn is the life for me.
Back at Terry's, life seemed so simple. And the sugar and the cereal fueled the delusion that any of us knew what to do with our lives. It was like we were all wearing pajamas again. Like Richie had never left Happy Days.
You guys, we gotta keep it down. Ever since Headboard did those egg exploding experiments in the microwave, Mom doesn't want the gang in here.
I'm not a gang.
We're a club.
Yeah, this is gonna be the best summer since we built the clubhouse.
Yeah, there's something really timeless about that summer.
We were kids then. We could do what we wanted.
What are you talking about? As soon as Laura gets on that plane, you are a free agent again.
Yeah, just in time, too.
I mean, look what happened to David.
All marriages don't end in nasty divorces.
Hey, would you please cut that out?
60% of them do.
Would you come out here, Lawrence Wilkes? You guessed it. I was giving you...
I cannot believe your brother ate all the fucking marshmallows.
While my friends whittled away at what was left of my backbone, Kate was where I should have been, with Laura.
Here you are, Laura. Why did you get out of the pool and go home?
I'm leaving in 3.5 hours, and he still won't talk about whether we're going to see other people or not.
He's a chicken, Laura, you know that. That's why I never learned to drive a stick shift, why I follows Rick and Terry's lead all the time. He's always been king of the chickens.
But John brings up the club and y'all's vow of bachelorhood every time we start to talk about things.
He's scared things will change if you guys commit. The club's important to him. To all of us.
Why?
It's kind of a bond between us all. Sort of a promise to be there for each other.
But I've been there for him when he's needed me. And he's been there for me. I mean, that's what I really like about him.
Well, it's your life, Laura. But my advice is, stay single, strong, and keep him securely under your thumb.
Keep them under your thumb. That's how you survive with women in this world.
Guy's got as much of a chance of having a happy marriage these days as you do sinking that two ball.
Or learning to drive a stick shift.
Get on the subject anyways. Besides, marriage doesn't have to be a prison, does it?
What do you think marriage would really be like, John?
Could be like...
You can relax. I'm home.
You poor son of a bitch. This is hopeless. His mind is stranded on the island of misfit toys.
We're losing him, Doctor. Should we try the Vulcan mind meld?
Mind meld? Look at that face. We're gonna have to shoot the bastard.
Yeah, well, what do you think marriage is really like?
Sure. Things may start out all right. With the honeymoon and all, but after a few years...
Really sick.
Bogart had it right in Casablanca.
Love him and let him go.
Look, I have to see Laura, so do you have a surprise for me or not?
No.
I mean, yes, but Terry has to help me get it upstairs.
John is too far gone. We're going to Code Red.
Batcave.
Terry?
Kate.
Is John over there?
Yeah, he's here. Just a second.
She wants to speak with John.
Hi.
What the fuck is this? Rick?
Look, where's John?
He's not here to this.
Terry said he was.
I mean, he's here, but he can't come to the phone right now.
Rick, if this is another one of your schemes, I swear...
Kate, don't you trust me?
No, and if you don't get John's chicken shit ass back here in 15 minutes, I'm gonna come drag it here.
Wait, Kate! Shit!
We have to get over to Laura's Warp 10.
The Wrath of Kate.
Look, where are those cuff actionables that Cher lookalike gave you?
Kara? My dresser, why?
Oh no. No way, no way!
No way, no way!
That's getting a little out of hand, Rick. Make sure John doesn't leave here.
Everyone
but you has this little red warning light that flashes inside their head and stops them before they go too far with something.
There's no such thing as too far.
There's only not far enough.
But I'm the one that always ends up covered with soy sauce in the middle of a field.
But at least that's a night you'll never forget.
And you'll never forget when John shoved you out of the clubhouse either. It does not mean that you're glad you broke your wrist.
Well,
okay. Okay, you made your point. I'll put my automatic red warning light back on, okay?
Come on, are we still that dynamic duo or what?
Okay. We go talk to Kate, and then we come back here and we try to convince John to change his mind. But if you get carried away with things, I'm out.
Okay. Now let's save John and stop this epidemic of marriages before we become its next hapless victims.
Howdy, BJ, and you unadulterated rebels. You cured John of his marriage fever yet, or what?
I knew it. You guys saw the ring.
Headboard.
Crush. Kill. Destroy.
I've been going out with her for 2 years. I mean, we're kind of together. What else am I gonna do?
What else are you gonna do?
I don't know. Get a sex change operation. Mainline heroin. Join the army. Anything, but don't get married because you're kind of together.
So what'd she say?
What do you mean?
Laura, when you asked her to marry you.
How could she say no to 007 here?
007? That's Triangle Fester.
Well, I think it's about time for your surprise now, John. Close your eyes and hold out your hands.
Rick, what the fuck? You can't do this. I need to see Laura.
You will. You will. Besides, you'll be with her the rest of your life. A goodbye, Mr. Bond.
Headboard? Wake up. Headboard, it was only water. You're not dead. You have to keep an eye on him. Here's a key in case of emergency. But don't give it to him or let him use the phone. Got it?
Rebelicious.
To the polls, Robin.
Where are you going? This isn't funny!
Yep. Nijeminski's in there, all right. Do not attempt to adjust the left-handed functulation, and he's still beating me.
Are you okay, headboard?
Yeah, totally. Excellent. How about you? You okay?
I ought to do this one.
Killer functionated baffle jam. Baffle jam.
Why don't you give me the one on your keychain?
Beerage.
Instead of being with Laura, I'd let myself get dragged into some lost S&M episode of My Three Sons, where Uncle Charlie drinks a can of paint thinner, Chip Douglas gets cuffed to a pole, and Fred McMurray, high on toadstools, whips him with a belt. Man, I knew one thing. I had to get out of there before the triplets arrived.
Could you let me out of these cuffs now, please? I really have to see Laura.
Sorry, doodoodle. Can't. Promised Rick.
But you see, she really didn't say yes. I mean, I slipped the ring on her finger while she was asleep, and I don't know if she wants to keep it or not.
You really love her, don't you?
I think so. But I thought it was supposed to make everything clear. And now I'm more confused than ever.
I'd really love to let you go, John. But I can't. I promised I wouldn't.
Well, can I at least take a piss?
Sure. Sure.
You could tell Headboard was zasted, not because of the way he talked, but because he forgot that on TV, prisoners never ask to go to the bathroom unless they're planning something. I had to get to Laura. I was determined not to end up like Chip Douglas, tied to the back of a speeding station wagon. I was getting out.
I'll tell you something.
A stick shift.
Well, she never saw the ring. John? John?
Left a few gears lying on the road learning how to drive Headboard's stick, but I had no idea that Headboard had started Terry's car. Terry couldn't even start his own car most of the time. The whole thing was held together with coat hanger wire and about a gallon of Bondo.
Bond. James Bond.
I figured all the beers Headboard drank were fast turning into yogurt inside his head, so I had to disable Terry's car before Headboard turned himself into a smear of highway paste. But the real threat to public safety was arriving at Laura's house to keep Kate from sabotaging their plot to make me a lifetime member of the Bachelor's Club.
Hey, guys. John with you?
No. He's not here yet?
No. Where is he? Maybe that's him.
I'll get it.
Hello?
Hello, Laura. This is Headboard. Look, you can't leave till he gets there, because he's on his way over. Okay?
Headboard, this is Rick.
Who's on his way over?
John is. And Rick loves him, so you can't leave, because it's really love.
Headboard,
are you at Terry's crib? Okay. You have to promise me not to try to go anywhere, or get in a car.
Or anything. Drink until dawn again, Headboard.
You're an animal.
What the hell's going on, Rick? I smell a rat, and I don't know if it's you, or John, or both of you. And you don't look too innocent either, Popeye.
John's gonna stay at Terry's house.
All right, Terry, cough it up. What are you guys up to? Great. Rick, if you don't go get John, I will.
It's his decision, Kate.
We're doomed.
She won't make it.
What did Headboard say? It was the first time he tried to speak English, and I couldn't understand a word he was saying. Except that I think John is on his way over. He must have played quarters with him again.
Who's on his way over here, John?
No, that was Headboard, and he said that he's on his way over. Because he has this incredible crush on you.
Headboard?
And he's coming over to tell you before you leave.
This is the last thing I need now.
I'll tell you what. If you can get your stuff together quickly, Terry can run you over to the airport, and I'll wait here for Headboard.
I don't know, Rick.
Trust me.
Where's Kate?
She'll be right back. We'll meet you at the airport.
What the hell is going on here?
Red lights, Rick. I'm seeing flashing red lights.
What? She's on that plane. Our troubles are over.
How? You heard what John said. They're already engaged.
She hasn't said yes to him yet. John lied. Look, it's for their own good.
Where the hell is the ring anyway?
I'm ready. I really figured Don would have at least had the guts to say goodbye.
Quick, in here.
It really is Headboard.
Soy sauce again.
Stay in the basement until I get you. I'll take care of him.
All right, but let me know.
Where is she?
Who?
You son of a bitch. I thought you guys were trying to louse things up between Laura and me. When all along you're trying to save me from making a fool of myself.
John.
Well, I didn't have the guts to face her to give it to her, so why should she have to face me to give it back? James Bond.
What the fuck just went on here? She gave the ring back to you?
Well, she didn't actually give it back to me. I took it before she woke up and saw it.
Son of a bitch! You and I are gonna go catch up with John and bring him back here.
Wait, what about the club and the way it used to be?
Used to be is history, man. We're not a club anymore. We're a fucking gang. I mean, look at the way we operate. Wait here.
Is Headboard gone yet?
Well, John thinks that Laura doesn't want to marry him.
And you let him leave believing that?
I didn't know Rick had taken the ring. Anyway, we gotta go catch up with John and tell him what happened. That fuckwad.
Laura's with them. Come on, we'll get John later.
Our minds are emerging. Becoming one. Our minds.
Hail.
What is with it for? Oh, I found him passed out in your car. He's trashed and only responding to Kirok.
Hardcore Benton, but have you been drinking again?
Stop by John. I really need to speak to him.
He's not there to dance. Besides, for an international flight, you should be there 2 hours beforehand.
Thank God we're not in your junkie, but we'd never catch him. Yeah. My car has a lot of character.
Yeah, we call Rustin Dance character.
Look, there they are. We should cut him off.
We'll take Beechwood.
We'll all die horribly. Red Jack, Red Jack, Red Jack.
He just ran another light. Take it easy, Rick.
I ran a light?
Son of a... Wait for John.
The realization slowly dawned on Rick that he had just discovered a fate worse than marriage. The near destruction of two vintage convertibles, along with himself and four of his closest friends. Whether it was more painful for Rick to watch those friends desert him, or to know he nearly tripled his own insurance premium, he finally realized that he had gone too far.
Scorned as the one who ran. What do you do when you're branded and you know you're a man?
What have I fucking done? John wouldn't go back to his house, guys.
No one really understood Rick, not me or his parents, not even his high school graduating class, who voted Rick most likely to be torn to pieces by an angry mob, not even the people he would later meet during his journey through the criminal justice system. But every troubled piece of trash has within them a tiny spark of humanity, something that lives and breathes and gives hope to others. Some say Rick's tiny spark grew 3 sizes that day.
John, are you okay?
Yeah, I was almost in the clubhouse when one of the ladder boards snapped. Guess I weigh a little bit more than I did then, huh?
It's been almost 10 years. I'm surprised it's even still here. John,
good news or bad news?
Both. The bad news is, well, I'm a selfish, manipulative dick.
So what's new?
The good news is,
Laura never saw the ring because I took it off her finger before she woke up.
So she hasn't said no.
And she's waiting for you back at your house, so if you hurry, there's still time.
You goddamn jerk. How could you do all of this?
I was trying to save you from making a mistake. But I guess maybe I went too far.
Maybe?
Okay, I went too far. But how do you know I'm not right?
I don't. But it's not your decision, Rick. It's mine.
And I guess you better be there to put her on that plane. Because if you don't, you'll probably regret it. Maybe not today or tomorrow, but the day after.
Despite the cheesy Casablanca reference, I was willing to forgive Rick, but the other still wanted his head spinning on a souvlaki spike.
You gotta go, you missed your plane.
Have a great time, Dudess.
Thanks.
And, again, I'm sorry I messed you up, but I swear this is the last time I ever get involved with one of Rick's schemes.
Let's go.
Get out. I'll drive her.
You can't drive a stick.
I just learned on headboard's transmission. Well, what's left of it?
Here.
You might need this.
The ring had finally come full circle. It was still cubic zirconium, but I had changed. I no longer feared a future with Laura, even if I didn't exactly know the way to the airport, and even if some of my friends still thought I'd be better off marrying the mannequin.
Just because you finally realized what a jerk you've been and brought John here, don't think you've made up for everything.
You think this is a happy end here?
It was a happy ending. Okay, maybe not like on the Donna Reed show, but happy enough for real life.
You almost fucking killed us!
All right. I went a little too far.
A little too far?
Hey, wait. Remember, we decided to wait for John. But while we waited, we had time to fill him with soy sauce.
Oh, this is my favorite shirt.
Aww.
That summer, I began to see beyond the TV fog into which we had drifted, and I figured out that Kirk and Spock can't ever watch the reruns of Star Trek that are beamed into outer space, because you can't have a TV life and a real life at the same time. If you did, you'd end up lost in place.
I am Kirk!
The story you have just seen is true. The names were changed to protect the innocent.